And welcome back to this new day of retreat. And today it's going to be a short intro video because I want to jump right into it. And I just want to say the word that we haven't been able to say in 40 days, and which I think we need to hear more than ever. And that is, Alleluia. Alleluia, He is risen. Friends, I know these are difficult times, but even in the midst of 100 questions and concerns and worries that you might have, I pray that you receive, that you and your loved ones receive a consolation from knowing that Christ has conquered death. This is a fact. It is a spiritual and historical reality, which has the power to reshape each and every one of our lives. Because how can life look the same when we know that Christ has overturned death? How can we come out of this unchanged? Honestly, once we let the power and the meaning of the resurrection wash over us and through us, there is not a part of our existence which will remain untouched. Jesus Christ died and rose again, and that changes everything. You know, in recent weeks, I've been pondering the words from Romans 8:28, a very well-known verse. We know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. We know that all things work for good, which is why even on the longest days, the hardest days, we can cry out, Alleluia. Friends, He is risen. He is truly risen. So I leave with you this song, The Gardener, which I wrote a number of years ago after reflecting on the story of Mary Magdalene meeting the risen Lord in the garden. So I pray that you enjoy the song and the accompanying written reflection. And friends, let us pray for one another on this day when around the world, millions of voices sing out in praise. Alleluia. God bless you all.